Hello aspirants, so today is December 11, 2019 and in this video lecture we are going to cover some 10 to 12 topics, recent topics and sources are Hindu, PIB, Indian Experts and some miscellaneous sources too and I am Shubhangini Dubey. Okay, so today we are going to discuss the topics. Topic 1 is a scheme by the Ministry of Tribal Affairs for the Scheduled Tribes Students in India, that means it is for the STs. Then World Anti-Doping Agency is there, its short form is WADA. Then there is another topic, Jahan Jhuggi Wahan Ghar Initiative. Then there is Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya, National Mission on Teachers and Training. Then there is a Skill Build Platform. Then Asian Elephant Specialist Group, then Eklavya Model Residential School, then International Court of Justice, that is ICJ, then Human Development Index HDI, then there is a White Island, then there is a Frog Phone and Railwire Wi-Fi. So beginning with the schemes by the Ministry of Tribal Affairs for ST students in India. So there are some schemes for the students who are belonging to the ST category. So basically the tribal ministry have implemented some schemes in the states and union territory across the countries. So what are these schemes? So first is pre-matric scholarship for the ST students. So this is for the students who are pre-matric. Then there is a post-matric. Matric is the 10th examination. Class 10th examination is the matric examination. So one is the pre-matric scholarship. Another one is post-matric scholarship for the ST students. And then national fellowship and scholarship for higher education for ST students is there, and then national overseas scholarship for ST students who are studying abroad. Okay, so for the students who are studying in abroad, there is scholarship. Then there are grant and aid to voluntary organization working for the welfare of the scheduled tribes. Okay, so there are some aids also, grant and aids given by the voluntary organization. Then there are strengthening education among ST girls in low literacy districts. So there are so many districts in across the states where the tribal population is there. So education of ST girls is also going to be strengthened. Okay, so there is the grant. It is under the Article 275(1) of the Constitution of India. So this, all these grants is in this, and then it is running on the Eklavya Model Residential Schools. Okay, so Eklavya Model Residential Schools are there. Then Special Certain Assistance to Tribal Sub Scheme. Okay, so it is, in short, it is known as SCA2 TSS. okay, then there is development of particularly vulnerable tribal groups, it is known as PVTGS. okay, so these are the various schemes for the ST students across India. Moving on to the another topic, that is World Anti-Doping Agency, in short it is known as WADA, WADA. Okay, so it is the World Anti-Doping Agency. It was established in 1999, so it's almost 20 years this agency has been established, and it is an international independent agency and funded by sport movement and the government of the world. Okay, so anti-doping agency is actually associated with the sports, and it includes the scientific research, education, development of anti-doping capacities, okay, and monitoring the World Anti-Doping Code, the document harmonizing anti-doping policy in all sports across all the countries. Okay, so it has, why it was in news and why it is in news, we are discussing it because recently Russia has been banned by the World Anti-Doping Agency for 4 years. Okay, so now from participation in global sporting events, Russia have been banned, including the 2020 Tokyo Olympics and 2022 Beijing Winter Olympics. Russia has been banned. Okay, so why it is? Because after accusing Moscow of falsifying data from an anti-doping laboratory. Okay, so this is the something, because in the Moscow there was an falsifying data from the anti-doping laboratory, and this is the reason Russia has been banned. Okay, so now Russians will not be in, from the sportsmen, sportsperson from Russia will not be able to participate in the Tokyo Olympics as well as in the Beijing Winter Olympics. Okay, so this was about the World Anti-Doping Agency. Then moving on to the another topic, Jahan Jhuggi Wahan Ghar Initiative. So as recently government has taken a decision that there will be the redevelopment of over 378 Jhuggi cluster in Delhi. Okay, there will be like there are so many clusters. Juggi clusters are there in New Delhi. So there will be like जहाँ जुग्गी वहाँ घर initiative. So basically under this initiative, land owned by the DDA, that is Delhi Development Association, and the land and development office will be redeveloped under the in situ slum redevelopment component of the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Okay, so there are Juggis, there will be the house will be prepared there. Okay, so this is about the Jahan Juggi Wahan Ghar initiative. Then another topic is Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya National Mission on Teachers and the Training. Okay, so this is the short form. This is like PMMMMTT. Okay, so it is a center sector scheme, that is central government is helping it, and it was launched in December 2014. Okay, so in the first time of the Modi government, it was launched and it will continue till March 2020. So basically it's a 6-year program, and what its mission is to provide quality teachers in schools and the colleges. So basically quality teachers should be there in the schools and colleges, and it will attract the talented people in the education sector and improve quality in the teachings. Okay, so basically this is for the teachers, that better teachers should be there in the school in order to enhance the education. Okay, and objective of this mission is to develop innovative teaching method. So basically innovative teaching method should be there developed, and high level education institutional facilities will be there in the schools, okay, and in the colleges, and no international collaborations with any approved school of education is there under this scheme. Okay, so it is in one of its kind scheme, and basically it is to have the mission is to aiming the teaching is to enhance the teaching standard across the country. Okay, so professional teachers will be created under this training mission. Moving on to the another topic, skilled build platform. Okay, so it is like in the skilled build platform, it will focus on personalized coaching and experiential learning. Okay, so skill build platform will somehow focus on skill building and skill required to join the workforce in the new collar roles. Okay, so there are so many criteria in which new skills is going to it will be there, new vacancies with new skills will be the need of the hour. So because of it also bring untapped talent to the fore, opening roles to individuals. So skill build platform is basically providing the skills to come in the new world for the youngsters. Okay, so skill build platform will provide personal assessment, okay, and via My Inner Genius to youths and students. So there will be the skill development program for the new collar roles. Now what is new collar role? So there are so many different collar works are there, pink collar, white collar. Regarding service sector, it is the white collar, then industries are there, then the different golden collars are there, businessmen's. Okay, so for the new collar roles, skill build platform will be there. Okay, so it will be accessible online through Bharat Skills. So under the Bharat Skills, skill build platform is there, and it will be a learning management system for the students and teachers, and it will be free to use. Okay, so this is the site I have mentioned here, and it can be accessible in the bharatskill.gov.in. Then another topic is Asian Elephant Specialist Group. Okay, so why we are discussing it? Because recently 10th Asian Elephant Specialist Group meeting was started at Kota Kinabalu in Sabah, Malaysia. Okay, Kota Kinabalu in Sabah, Malaysia. Malaysia is the country where this meeting happened. That is the 10th Asian Elephant Specialist Group meeting was there. So the IUCN is a global network of voluntary specialists. So IUCN ASESG, that is, it is a global network of voluntary specialists. And there are the scientists and non-scientists which are studying, monitoring, management, and also doing the conservation steps are being taken for the conservation of Asian elephants. Okay, so the aim of this group, basically the aim of this group is to promote the long-term conservation of Asia's elephant. Now Asia's elephants will be conserved and their recovery should be there, that there should be no problem, and the species should be conserved anyway. Okay, and why it is happening? Because the group acts as a red list authority for the Asian elephant. So now, as of now, so many species are getting extinct. Okay, so in order to conserve and having the ecological balance, this is being carried out. Okay, so it will carrying out red list assessment for inclusion in the IUCN red list. So then it will be in the red list somehow. So there are currently over 110 volunteer member from 18 countries. Okay. So if there will be the if it IUCN red list if the elephants will be in the IUCN red list, so somehow the measures to conserve them will be raised. Okay, so this is it, and as we have there are 18 countries from the 18 countries in which 110 voluntary members are there, and Asian elephant, that is Elephas maximus, the name is Elephas maximus, that exist in 13 states. So in the 13 states, these Asian elephants are existing. Okay, so they are the major aim is to conserve the Asian elephants. Moving on to the next topic, Eklavya model residential school. Okay, so we just discussed it in the first news, Eklavya model residential school for the ST students. So what it is? Okay, so recently the second national level sports meet for students was inaugurated in Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh, and it was the for the Eklavya model residential school. Okay, so what is it? Its objective is to provide quality middle and high level education. Okay, it will be the quality middle and high level education for the scheduled tribe students in the remote areas. It is not for the scheduled caste. Okay, keep this in mind. Eklavya model residential school is only for the scheduled tribe, not for the scheduled caste. Okay, so wherever density of ST tribe is higher in identified sub district, it is proposed to set up the Eklavya model day boarding school. So anywhere there is a high population of scheduled tribe students, there will be the development of Eklavya model residential school will be there. Okay, and a boarding school will be made. Okay, so the school will focus not only on the academic education but on the all round development of the students. Okay, so it will not be focusing on the academic, but also it will be a overall development especially in the sports as well. Okay, so as per the budget which was passed in 2018-19, every block with more than 50% ST population and at least 20,000 tribal people will have an Eklavya model residential school by year 2022. So this is the thing, that according to the budget, if there is any population which is having at least 20,000 tribal people, that is 50% ST population, then there will be this school. Okay, and implementation of schemes will be reviewed by the Union Ministry of Tribal Affairs. So whatever schemes and benefits are for the tribal people, Union Ministry of Tribal Affairs look after it. Okay, and the Ministry of Tribal Affairs conduct the review meeting, which state and union territories would be required to make presentations on the program progress of their EMRS. Okay, that means Eklavya model residential school. So meeting, the report will be prepared by the state government. Moving on to the next topic, International Court of Justice. So recently the Nobel laureate Aung San Suu Kyi is in the Hague defending Myanmar against charges of carrying out a genocide against its Muslim Rohingya minority. Okay, so this is the thing that Aung San Suu Kyi just defended the Myanmarist and against the charges, there was a genocide against the Muslim Rohingya minority. So the Gambia, which is predominantly Muslim, went to ICG in November 2019. Okay, so accusing Myanmar of the genocide. So a predominantly Muslim was the Gambia, and it went to the ICJ, that is International Court of Justice, in November, in the previous month only, and they said that Myanmar is accused of the genocide. Then the International Court of Justice, it is established in 1945, and after half a century of international conflict in the form of two world wars. Okay, so it is a principal judicial organ of the UN, as we know that is a principal judicial organ of UN, and it is established through the adoption of UN charter. A UN charter was made, and then the ICJ was established. Okay, so more about the ICJ is that the court is composed of the 15 judges are there in the court, and they are elected for term of office of 9 years by the United Nations General Assembly and the Security Council. So the term of the judges is 9 years, and its official languages are English and French. So English and French are its official languages. And ICJ is different from the ICC. So there are two different courts. One is International Court of Justice and the another one is International Criminal Court. Okay, so it is a permanent tribunal created to prosecute individual for genocide, crime against humanity, war crimes or the crime of aggression. So whatever criminal cases are there which are in the international level, it goes to International Criminal Court. Okay, and whereas the International Court of Justice, it is a primary judicial organization of the United Nations. Okay. So, the Rome Statute, a multilateral treaty, is the foundation and governing document of the ICC. Okay, so a Rome Statute is there which governs there, like there is a constitution, a written something, written provisions are there. So, Rome Statute is a multilateral treaty and which is the foundation of governing document of International Court of International Criminal Court. Okay. Moving on to the next topic, Human Development Index. Okay, so why we are discussing it? Because India has climbed one spot to 129th in 2019 Human Development Index, which was released by the UNDP. Okay, so Human Development Index was created. So basically it is created to understand that how much human development is happening in all aspects, and there are some key dimensions that is in the Human Development Index. First is whether the long and healthy life is there, then being knowledgeable, okay, and have a decent standard of living. These are the criteria of the Human Development Index. Okay, so it is a geometric mean of normalized indices for each of the three dimensions. Okay, so somehow the report says that around 27.1 crore people in India were lifted out of poverty between 2005-6 to 2015-16. So this number of people, okay, this number of people have been lifted out of poverty in a decade from 2005 to 2016. Okay, now Human Development Index basically does not reflect the inequalities, poverty, human security, but the upliftment. Okay, so India is the largest country, constituting 41% of world's poor, according to the report. This is irony that India has slipped one rank above, but still it is the largest country which is having 41% poor, as according to the UNDP report. Moving on to the next topic, White Island. Okay, so why we are discussing it? Because recently the volcano in the White Island erupted. Okay, so where it is? It is in New Zealand. It is New Zealand's most active cone volcano, which was built by more than 150,000 years of volcanic activity. So it is still active volcano, and it has also dubbed as one of the most accessible active volcano. This volcano can be accessed. Okay, accessible. Then moving on to the another topic, frog phone. Okay, so what it is? So it is the world's first solar powered remote service device. Okay, and it can be installed at any frog pond which receive a 3G or 4G cellular network. So this is about the frog phone. At any frog pond it can be installed, and it is developed by a team of various Australian institutions. So Australian institutions have developed this, and it will allow researchers to dial these devices remotely and analyze the data later. Okay, so it will be the solar powered remote service device, and it will reduce cost and risk, including the negative impact on human presence on the field site. Okay, so solar powered remote service device is there, and it receives a 4G cellular network, and the device also allows for monitoring of local frog populations more frequently than before, which is important because these populations are recognized as indicator of the environmental health. So the number of frogs somehow is the indications of the environment health. So this is about frog phone. Then another and the last topic is RailWire Wi-Fi. Okay, so it is a retail broadband initiative of the RailTel. Okay, and it will extend the broadband and application service to the public. The Wi-Fi stations have been provided in association with the Google as a technology partner. So Google is the technology partner, and it is a corporation, Mini Ratn. It is in the RailTel is a Mini Ratn category 1 PSU of Ministry of Railway. Okay, so there are so many categories, Mini Ratna, then another is Ratna 2. So there are the categories of the corporations and the public sector undertaking. So it is in the Mini Ratna category 1. Okay, and Realtel Corporation, it is the largest neutral telecom services provider in the country. Okay, so this is about the RealWire Wi-Fi. Okay, and broadbands are there nowadays, like bigger stations are already having Wi-Fi connectivity. Okay, so aspirants, this was today's lecture. And for more details and more updates, just daily log into Plus Pravesh 11 and you will be getting the lectures on the daily basis. And thanks for watching.